Hello, I'm Bill Valerio, and I run Woodmere Art Museum, where we tell the stories of Philadelphia's art and artists. Jazz is an art form we are dedicated to presenting at Woodmere, and this short video is part of a series that will capture highlights from the outdoor jazz concerts we presented with Warren Ory and the Arpeggio Jazz Ensemble on the front lawn of Woodmere in the fall of 2020. Everyone brought their own lawn chairs, set them up 6 feet apart, brought a picnic basket or a glass of wine, and with masks and social distance, had a great time. We are calling this series of videos Jazz from the Art. And so please be on the lookout every Saturday. We will release a new video on Woodmere's website, send a link through social media, and send reminders in our bi-weekly newsletters. Our intention is to build excitement for the new series of outdoor Saturday night jazz concerts that will be resuming this coming spring, starting in May. We are making these videos with the sole purpose of sharing the beauty and staying in touch. However, we encourage that if you are in a position to support jazz at Woodmere, please become a member, renew your membership, or make a donation at WoodmereArtMuseum.org and click on the donate button in the upper right of the homepage. Warren, it's great to be here with you today, and we're going to talk about Larry Price, saxophone player, and his performance in Mood Indigo, which is, you know, out of this world somewhere, right? I mean, he gets into that piece of music in a way where he transports himself everybody else along with him.
Yes. Like he does with almost every piece of music he does. I mean, Larry Price, I met him a few years ago when he just moved here from North Carolina. And it was, you know, music at first sight, you might say.
We were well, you could say love at first sight.
Well, you know. But it was.
Yeah.
Because I loved his sound. Yeah. We were on a gig with Lisa Chavoux. And I never, you know, with Lisa, I like working with Lisa because you never know who's going to be on her gig. She always has different artists. And I never ask because I want to be surprised. So I showed up and here's this guy with glasses and a saxophone. I'm looking at him. Is he all right? And, you know, he's kind of looking at me. You know, musicians do that. They say, okay, let me see what this cat got. What can he do? And by the time we got 1 minute into the first tune, I knew I wanted his number. And he felt the same way. So he does it because that tune, Mood Indigo, is such a beautiful tune. Again, it's a testament to Duke Ellington's compositional skills and his ability to take his ideas and plant them inside of you, inside of your soul. And then, how many people were calling blue indigo? But that's what it is, it's a type of blue. And so that Mood Indigo just fits it so well. Now, Duke has done it several ways, you know, depending on who he had, Ben Webster or his main man, Johnny Hodges, who used to kill that tune. But Larry, I said, because Larry does some good intros to tunes where you're not sure what it's going to be until you start getting glimpses of it. And I told Larry, I said, man, why don't you just open up the tune with just a solo, just you by yourself. Open it up and then just take us to the door when it's time. And you'll hear that in this composition, how he opens it up, and when he gets close to the door, he opens it up, and then the rest of us come in there. And the tune, again, being such a great tune, it feels so good when, you know, ba da da da. Oh, man, that takes me back, Even though I wasn't born yet or lived yet, I feel like here it is, 1932, and I'm in the Savoy Ballroom with Johnny Hodges and Duke Ellington and Warren Ory on bass.
Yeah.
So it's a nice, soulful, slow ballad, but not, it's not really a sad ballad, but it's contemplative. John Coltrane said music can be celebrative or contemplative, and this is definitely one of those contemplative ballads that Larry does so well, that Duke Ellington wrote so well.
It's interesting because, you know, you talk about, you know, indigo as a form of blue.
Right.
But it's a very specific kind of blue. I mean, mm-hmm. we're in an art museum, right?
Right.
And so, you know, indigo is a deep, dark, rich, nuanced mm-hmm. blue. It's right. not a sad blue.
Right. Exactly.
But it's deep.
It's intense.
It's intense. Yeah. Mm-hmm. When you know, and when you see indigo, it takes you somewhere.
Yeah. That's
interesting. I never really thought of it in terms of color.
Right.
Because, I mean, I know that color means something different in music mm-hmm. than it means in visual art, right. but actually they're related.
Sure. They meet.
Yeah.
They meet at that crossroads.
Yeah.
Without a doubt.
Well, we're going to hear that in this clip.
Let's hear this blue.
And Larry really is out of sight
yes.
in this.
Great player.
As always, but this
That's
clip,
right.
he shines.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Thank you.
Larry Price putting us in that blue mood, that mood indigo.